Lord, he is seated under the unctions of the Holy Spirit. Bless the Lord as he speaks to our God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Praise the Lord. We are so blessed to be in this part of the world where we could hopefully worship the Lord in spirit and truth and self. Right from the inception that we started this, commenced this service today, we would see the Lord mighty in the Holy Spirit. You know, at times when we see the Lord speaking to us in the Holy Spirit, you know, He speaks to each of you. Even if you see the scripture which was written, it was not written at one go, everybody spoke to each other.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God.
Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ came full of grace and full of power. So that's what we have seen. It was only the beginning, the world. Now, if you see, he was in the world, though the world was made for him, the world did not recognize him. He came to the world which was of his own. You know, but his own did not receive him. Yet, all who received, all who believed in his name, he gave the right to become the children of God. So when you believe the word, when you believe Jesus Christ, when you accept him as a personal savior, you become a child of God. Now, Hebrew 1:3 says, see, it's all, we have to just give the word in the self-explanatory, you don't have to go and expound it, the Holy Spirit reveals to us. He says, the Son is the radiance of the God's glory, and the exact definition of his being, sustaining all things by the power of the word. So everything the Lord wants, even the word, if you think of in the world, what is holding on? This people call, the scientists talk about the G-force. But nobody could explain this. It's a force which holds the thing 9.8, which is the G, the scientists can tell us. But it is the task for us, every machinery works because the force is holding it. It's not holding everything in yours. So he holds everything as the word of God. All the planets in the universe, when they rotate on its orbit, they rotate. If they go otherwise, they go colliding with each other, there won't be any light. But he holds everything. He's the Lord who is in control. He has made each one of us. And he desires that we worship him in spirit with his heart, with our heart. And that's what our heart is the main thing. See, we don't require any instruments, we don't require anything, but he requires your heart to come and then come into that. We might be in the wilderness, but we have a heart right in the presence of the Lord. That's what it matters. And sometimes it's amazing, you know, there's a confirmation when the Lord is sharing Jeremiah 23:29. It's not my word like fire, declares the Lord. And like a hammer that breaks it off in pieces. You know, the Lord amazingly breaks, you know, even if you are hard. So a heart has to be very susceptible or very, you know. The heart is the main thing of our any human being. You know, sometimes we have very stubborn hearts and we will not take the word. We might listen to Samson and come out, but we will not. Now, even it says in the book, so I'm just laying the foundation before to start the word about the heart. And now from infancy you have known. How the known the Holy Scripture. This is in 2 Timothy 3:15-17. Which says, which are able to make you wise for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. Faith will also come by heart. We cannot go without that. Because unless the faith is there in the heart, we cannot believe in Christ. All scriptures God breath and useful for teaching, rebuking, guiding, and training in righteousness, so that the servant of God may be thoroughly equipped for every good work. You know, when we read the word, when we take it to heart, accept it, that's what the actual thing works in our life. Now, as we said, reference is only from the word of God which is there. And every time as we read the word is being shared, it is shared. You know, the word is Hebrews 4:12-13 says, for the word of God is alive and active. Then any double is what? It penetrates even to dividing soul and spirit, joints and marrow, it judges the thoughts and attitudes of the heart. You see, it judges the thoughts and attitudes of the heart. You know, so our thought is in the mind, attitudes in the heart is what we are talking about. Nothing in all creation is hidden from God's sight. Everything is under what a day fair before the eyes of him to whom we must give account. Now it's very vital that we will give account to the Holy One. You know, even if you ask, I was sharing with a couple of Muslim brothers and I was talking, so what do you believe about Christ? He said, yeah, he's going to come back. They believe Christ is going to come back for judgment. They also believe. Now, what is the way of judgment? What is his standard of judgment? It is from the heart. Everything what we have thought in our heart, doesn't matter how good we look, how good we present, but what is in our heart is what matters. You know, in the word it is said that there were people who had no guile in their hearts. Was not, I mean, David was called after man, David was called a man of God's heart. He always walked in alignment with the word of God. And even when he appointed the deviation, he always came on his Lord and coming back to him. If you see the parable of the sword, what Jesus has said, his disciples asked him, you know the parable? So, what we have to do is we have to create a standard. And similarly, the word of God is said, when we accept it into our heart, which is there, and it becomes a way of life. But sometimes it becomes so ideal, it's what Jim used to say, let's go back to this. Because we don't even, sometimes we get so involved with people work and things which we have to tell, we don't even see the guest coming in or, you know, bringing the guest or missing things which we miss out. So it's always good to go back to the basics what the word of God says to us. He says, the meaning of what he has said is very simple. The word he says, he talked about it in the different instances where the word. If you say the verse 11, what he says, the meaning of the parable, the seed is the word of God. And along with the part of the seed, that it hears and that the devil's come to take away the word from the hearts, so that they can be not believe in saying. You know, it's very important that we can, we have grown up into a Christian environment, grown up, and we take it for granted. You know, the body of Christ is what the God's base is, we take it for granted and we say. Because the heart is very sometimes Bible and it just becomes so stubborn and think, I have been listening every time and read that the word which always, which is very clearly essential to the word. So they say that, so they may not believe and be saved. See, the main thing is if you don't believe, you can't be saved. And that's why the heart has to come to know that the vital role of heart. So that which is a rocky ground, the different instances they have given. There are three. One is which falls on the roadside, which the devil takes away because it doesn't take root before even it comes to the heart. Then there's another one which is the belief. There is a time of testing which now falls away. There's a little pressure of life, it falls away and they make it move. The seed that fell among the thorn is also there. They get a little thing, but they cannot because there is a pressure of the, around the world. Which is the worries, the riches, the pleasure, and the, they do not get mature. Before it is mature, it has been subsided and it does not. But the word says in 15, Luke 8:15, but the seed of the good soil stands for those with a noble and a good heart, who hear the word retaining and are preserving it. See, that is the only great person deserves. Proof. That is the only thing that you have a right and a heart is God, yes. Similarly, you have to accept. You know, Rachel was very beautifully sharing about the word family. You become so familiar with the word, what else for in there? You become so insensitive. Yeah, after you come, you see the Lord, you know. Outside, people come and get impressed, but we, even when we are in the city in the house of the Lord, we get very complacent. Is it we have heard a word from a childhood, attended churches, carried out the rituals in the Lord's prayer. You see, in the Lord's prayer, so powerful, we prayed, you know, one sister, three, I have shared. And it's so amazing in me. It's a Lord's prayer to me. But when you allow the Lord to do that, you always want the Lord to do that. And it doesn't happen like that. You say, Lord, why did it not happen? Why did it not happen? Why did it like that? You always keep questioning about the Lord. But when we say, Lord, what's the least thing that you know? When we just go and come to this, Lord, you do. Because you are in control, we are your children. Well, Lord says the earth is mine and everything belongs to me. You know, so the Lord says there's nothing to part from me. There's nothing. You have to just believe in your heart. The heart will only allow you to believe. If you don't believe in the heart, you will not move to anything further. Not even in the Jesus' own hometown, they could not do the Jesus could do much better because the people have said, oh yeah, he is a carpenter's son, we have seen him grow here. No, going back, what is the attitude of our heart? And what should be the attitude of our heart? What the Lord desire of us? Philippians 2:5-11 says, in your relationship with one another, have the same mindset as Jesus Christ. It says in Philippians 2:5, in some of the versions it says, you should have the same attitude as of Jesus Christ. And what does it say? He was God himself. He did not consider equality something to be grasped. You know, rather he was taking the very nature of the servant, being made in human likeness. Appearance of the man, but what did he do? First thing is he humbled himself. And then he became obedient to death, even death. never permitted to affect me. Come to me, not you who have been in your life, not your this. Because he comes in the soul. He says, I'm gentle and humble, and I'm blessed in you. You know? And even in Matthew, you see, 23, 11, and 12, the greatest of them, you know, the disciples were saying, who's the greatest among us? You know, that was, even if not every day, it was even the time of Christ, everybody used to go around and say, Lord, who's the greatest? You know, whether Peter, John, everybody used to have a sort of, what do you call that, competition among the disciples. And Lord said, for those who exalt themselves,
as we read in the Philippians,
please, you know, we are striving towards working towards Jesus. You know, what would Jesus do? You know, there are a lot of places that we have to give to youngsters. Jebel, what would Jesus do? You know, when you're in that situation, if you are into some temptations and sin, what would Jesus do? And that's always reminds them, see, what would you do in that situation? And so similarly, we are minded, because in, we are living in the world, see, except this few minutes or few hours that we sit in the presence of the Lord, to go back into the world. And to fight against this whole lot of media and everything is there. Now it's only unless we are grounded into the word of God, we cannot stand. Very easy, and the word also the parable was said that the person who made a foundation, the foundation was what is talking about. And Jesus is a rock, and we have a foundation on that rock. We cannot be shaken.
And what does this say? If you read the entire scripture, In the hope that he will forgive you for having such a thought in your heart. You know,
accepted Christ, but again he had been still captive to bitterness and sins. You know, Simon answers, pray to the Lord, but the Lord here says nothing happens to me. You know, actually immediately says, just pray because I have, you know, done wrong. You know, at times we have come from different cultures, different backgrounds, but we have not read the word because we have run into our upbringing, and we have believed that. Job says, the godless in heart harbor resentment. You know, so yes, body of Christ when we have come, we don't hold any resentments, no grudges. We say, Lord, we thank you that you have blessed us. And even in the Lord's prayer, he says, Lord says, God forgive us and we will forgive us. Which is a very vital thing of our growth. And in the last, after the completion of the prayer, he says, if you don't forgive others, and sometimes we don't take it to heart. We say, it's okay, I'll hold my Lord. You do not know how much I have faced the problem, I have faced the, you know, thing. You don't know my situation. Why I should hold it? Leave it. Why I have to hold it? You know? And the Lord has given the parable about that also. He has told about the person who was owning very large value, he was looking for giving. But he goes out and chose the other person to go and let him go. And it was a parable Lord has given in that instance. How can you? You have to let him go. Now, this is all about from the heart, you know, that we have the heart which unforgiveness, resentment, bitterness, all the things that we come, it's not become, that there is nothing. Now, if you see in the worldly wisdom, sometimes we can talk about that, and, you know, I'm keeping my point to the heart now. This is all about the heart. James, it says, James 3:13-16. Now, who is wise and understanding among you? Let him show it by good life. By days done, the humility that comes from wisdom. Now, when we come, what if you have a bitter envy and selfish ambition in your hearts, do not boast about it. Such wisdom does not come down from heaven, but is earthly, unspiritual, and demonic. So, if you hold the bitter envy and selfish ambition in our hearts, this is not from the Lord. We say, oh, this is worldly wisdom, brother, I will be offspring, I will be, you know, something. In my corporate world, I would we have to say, Lord, yes, you will see us through. Because he says, for where there is envy and selfish ambition, they will find themselves in the way even practice. Wherever it is there, they will find it. This is not the presence of the Lord. You know, we have to assess where the presence of the Lord is. And Lord really, basically, you know, the Pharisees used to read things to go in and out. They could see everything, but went down to the view. But application in their heart was different. And Matthew 5:15 says, for I tell you, unless your righteousness surpasses that of Pharisees and the teachers of the law, you will certainly not enter the kingdom. No, it's very important because if we have a Pharisee attitude, we will say, if you see the Lord Jesus Christ, whenever the Pharisees and the, you know, the people used to come, the people who were sinners, they would come. Lord has always said, come, my daughter, come, my son. The Pharisees, because in their hearts, they always want to be, so can we just ask a question to prepare or to ask him whether it is in the right? What does it say in Proverbs 16? To the human belongs the plan of the heart, to the Lord, but from the Lord comes the proper answer of the tongue. All the person may seem pure to them, but motives are made for the Lord. Motives of the heart are always made by the Lord. Whether the right motive I was talking to someone, for the right attitude. Lewdness, envy, slander, arrogance, and folly, all these evils come from inside for the world. see in front of the spirit, the heart. Who probes the heart? It's the Lord who probes the heart. No, we can't say no. What does it say in Jeremiah 17? The Lord, the heart is deceitful above all things and beyond pure wisdom and understanding. I, the Lord, sow the heart and examine the mind. You know, when rewarding a person according to his conduct, according to what his deed is. You know, the Lord is going to reward each person. We have read it in Hebrew. What does it say? That each person will be accounted and given what he has been. You know, Hebrew, what he said in 4:12-13. So, Lord is going to give account of everyone. Jeremiah 20:12. I'm just running through the scripture because the scripture is having the same scripture. I don't have to expound more on that. Lord Almighty, this is Jeremiah 20:12. You examine the righteous and both the heart and mind. You know, that's what the Lord does. Now, what is required of us? Now, if you know about these things, what is required of us to do? David, when we always take an example, he says in Psalm 51, he always, when he said, he went back to God, said, Lord, create me as your God, and renew our steadfast spirit. And what does he say? He says, my sacrifice to God is a broken and a contrite spirit. No, that's what he will not despise. He always love that. He always want that they come with a broken and a contrite spirit. No, they come in presence. Psalm 139, when he says, he said, Lord, where can I flee from your presence? If I go to the depths you are there, if I go to the other side of the sea, your hands will guide me. You know, anywhere in the globe you go, the Lord is going to us. So he says, search me, Lord. The last thing he said in concluding, Lord, search me, God, and know my heart. Test me and know my anxious thoughts. You know, see if there's any offensive in me and lead me to the way that I am. You know, it's very important that we say, Lord, you are serving me. You see what is there. Anything you give it, show me that I open my heart, correct myself. See, what is actually the believing the word of God is only just acknowledging in our heart and accepting it from out. And that's all your salvation, you know. Now, the word has been just negotiating partly in the last day. So it's very important for the issues that we come. For every week after we take it, and even in the days of early church, Acts mentioned they used to meet every day. Every day used to meet a week of bread, and they say, Lord, we just take the body of the Lord Jesus Christ, sharing the blood. And what it says, 1 Corinthians 11:28, everyone ought to examine themselves before they eat of the bread and drink from the cup. For those who eat and drink without discerning the body of Christ, eat and drink. So God has asked us to judge ourselves. How do we judge? Judge in accordance with the word of God. And when we judge, we see, Lord, if there's any harm, we may have done, go and ask dependent from you, from that person, and that's what, you know. But as we move forward, Lord's grace is there. He, you know, he increases our sensitivity into our spirits, into our hearts. And when we grow, we become less and less, you know, prone to that what we do every day when we come. So it is not a, when we are coming to the presence of the Lord, we should not be judged. And that's what the heart of the Lord desires. It is not what house we live in, what family we live in. The Lord is always concerned with our heart. Our hearts guide along the path of the Lord. And are we in right dealing with the Lord? The Lord of will give them a mind of my heart and put a new spirit in them. I will remove from them a heart of stone and give them a heart of flesh. You know, it's very important that Lord give us to live with a heart of stone. You know, when we have a stubborn heart, we cannot do anything. We are insensitive to the word of God. We can hear it, pain, we have, but it will not affect. The moment we become sensitive, we will repent, as the Lord will repent, become in your presence, surrender to ourselves, and the power of the Lord Jesus Christ walks into our lives. And what does it say?
Thank you.
I'll just quickly come to the close of this. There's one thing I would urge you to go and read. I was reading and I was blessed greatly by Ephesians 4. No, when we come together as the body of Christ, there are certain traits that have been asked to do, certain things that we've been asked to follow. When we come as the body of Christ and we come to listen, you know, there's a power in the unity. There's a dwelling of the waters. So there's a power of the waters. The Lord says, you know, in Timothy, God will just come for one time of something like that. Let's pray. We look into it with respect to our hearts. Lord, search me and see if there is anything which is not in alignment with you. Pray that God will be with us. You will be convicted. You know, when we see the first transformation in Acts here, when Peter had gone there, this is the people who have cut into their heart. And that's why we come to the belief.
Your name is glorified for our lives.
When we work into our
Thank you, brother.
God bless you. Thank you, brother.